Hey everyone, it's B-25 Mitch here. This is a short video that covers a few basics about Nuclear Options' new aircraft, the EW-25 Medusa. Let's start by doing a short takeoff. By default, auto-vectoring is enabled, and we're going to leave it that way for this demonstration. Hold down the wheel brakes and throttle up to maximum. When the thrust starts to overcome wheel grip, release the brakes and the aircraft will rapidly accelerate. At just over 100 km per hour, the vectoring mode will switch to takeoff, providing enough pitch authority to gently lift off. Once above 250 km per hour, retract the gear. Vertical landings are a little more tricky, but can also be done in auto-vectoring mode. We'll start our approach at 5 km away from the destination. Once landing gear is lowered, the auto-vectoring system will either use reverse mode if throttle is less than 90%, or takeoff mode if throttle is greater than 90%. We can use this fact to control the speed of approach, switching between reverse and takeoff positions with the throttle to manage airspeed. As the landing pad approaches, keep the throttle just under 90% to slow down as fast as possible. As the aircraft slows below stall speed, you'll need to pitch up a little to avoid descending too fast. Once airspeed drops below 110 km per hour, vectoring mode will automatically switch to hover. At this point, the aircraft can be flown like a helicopter. When hovering at low speed, the green line in the center of the HUD can be used to gauge horizontal velocity and make corrections in order to descend vertically. As you're about to touch down, reduce throttle to zero and hold the wheel brake. The aircraft should make a firm touchdown and may bounce slightly. Shortly after touchdown, the auto-vectoring system will return to the forward position, allowing you to taxi. The Medusa comes with wingtip antenna, which allow it to precisely locate radar sources from long ranges. It also has some unique weapons that give it exceptional capabilities against anti-aircraft missiles. First among these is the 120 kilowatt laser, which can destroy enemy missiles at ranges of up to 15 kilometers and up to 30 degrees of angle off boresight. The laser draws from the aircraft's capacitor, which should ideally be kept above 50% charge for best performance. If charge drops too low, the laser may not be able to draw enough power to destroy missiles, especially at longer ranges. The Medusa can also carry ARAD-116 anti-radiation missiles, which seek out enemy radar sources. They can be fired at pre-selected targets, or fired with no target selected, allowing them to lock onto sources that they find after launch. ARAD-116s are very powerful when combined with radar jamming pods. These pods can transmit radar-disrupting signals to targets at any angle, including behind the Medusa, and prevent targeted units from using their radar entirely. While ARAD-116s are inbound to target, continuing to fire the radar jamming pods at the target will prevent it from detecting the incoming missiles. All of these capabilities combine to make the Medusa a formidable presence, easily capable of turning the tide of a battle.